We have been discussing Ole Gunnar Solskjaer and that long-term new contract that he signed yesterday at Manchester United. Lewis, the Manchester United fan, has called up. Lewis, are you in favour of this decision?
Hi, guys. No, definitely not, Alex. I agree with you. Darren, I spoke to you yesterday.
Yeah, you did. I remember, Lewis.
This is a bad day for United, I'm afraid. It's only the Ole in fans who you know, just keep backing him because he's a United legend. It's the only reason why they're backing him. And it's all our rival fans who are happy because they know we're not going anywhere under Ole. United aren't a threat in terms of winning the league or the Champions League, the big trophies. That's why they're happy as well. This has been on the cards. We knew he was going to get a new contract. The club just are happy with top four, and that's Ole. That's all he's going to give you is top four. There's no next step. He's not going to win the league and finish above Guardiola's, Klopp's, now Thomas Tuchel's. He hasn't got it in him. Alex, as you said, he bottles it in the latter stages when he's so close to winning a trophy, i.e. all the semis he's lost and now a final. He gets out-thought, out-tacticed. The guy just makes the same mistakes again. Ole has had his chance. He's been here 2.5 years. He only got the job because he was a United player, ex-United player, and he keeps being given more and more time because, you know, of that fact. Another bad decision from Woodward. He's made a catalogue. I can't wait till that bloke goes. This is not good. I don't keep, you know, everyone said, oh, well, you know, I finished second. You know, I scored the second most goals. So what? We scored 9 goals in one game. That boosted that stat up, massive in one game.
It was a poor league as well, Lewis, wasn't it? When you look at Liverpool underachieved.
Means nothing. We were distant second. We were never in a title race. Chelsea have shown how quickly you can progress. That's progression. They went from nowhere, Chelsea, in December to champions of Europe in 6 months because they got a world-class manager in. We should have got Thomas Tuchel. We should get Conte. You know, even if we get
the players we want, like Varane, Conte.
And one or two others, Ole is still going to make the same mistakes with the team, line-up, the tactics. He's just clueless. The backroom staff should go as well, like Carrick's of the world. The whole club is a mess, right? We're not going to win anything under Ole. It's as simple as that. He's had his time, Colton. You only keep saying, giving him more time, more time, more time. He's had his time.
Yeah.
He's got to go.
It's
been 5 years since we won a trophy. Mm. It's just not good enough.
What you're saying, but I'm telling you that the people that are running the club, they're the ones that want Ole in because they're satisfied with his progression and they see him progressing in the future, near future, because they've been close so much. I know that you say it's bottling it. They're not looking at it as bottling it. They're looking at it as, oh, we're there, we're almost there. That's the way they're looking at it as owners. But it's not good enough, and I agree with you, it's not good enough for Man United and their stature.
Lewis made a good point there, and thanks for the call. 0871 722 3344 is the number if you have a view on Manchester United and Ole Gunnar Solskjaer in particular. The point you made there about Chelsea, there was a lot of uproar among their supporters when Frank Lampard was fired because, of course, he's a club legend, led them into the top four. Roman Abramovich didn't think he was the man for the job, didn't think they were heading in the right direction, didn't think they were going to win trophies under Frank Lampard.
Does he think anyone's the man for the job?
Well, yeah, but
every 2 years he changes.
He made a brave decision because he knew that it would tarnish his relationship with Frank Lampard. Mm. I know he was conscious of that, but he made the right decision because they won the Champions League.
Yeah. No, I'm there with you, definitely. But this is a scenario you lot find yourself in. And now you just got to understand that that's where your club sees you. The people that the powers that be at your club, they see you as a top four club and challenging, not winning anything. And that's where the problem lies. And that's not good enough for Man United fans. And of course, the Man United fans are going to be disgruntled. They're going to have to be disgruntled because they know where they come from. They know their heritage. They know what they're about. But this is mediocre. This is why I said this is mediocre, because it is for Man United. Coming second place is mediocre for Man United. Am I lying?
Well, no, but Darren Ambrose is a Spurs fan, so finishing second for them, they'd be an open-top bus parade.
Listen, Van Gaal was here, Moyes, Mourinho, none of them won the league.
No, but they won trophies.
They won trophies, didn't win the league.
And Mourinho
second in the league, I'm saying, isn't mediocre.
Mourinho finished second in a stronger league, you could argue. Yeah. Let's bring in Mike, the Manchester United fan. Mike, what's your thoughts on all this?
Yeah, Crooks, how you doing, guys? Everyone in the studio. Listen, I was having a good time cooking up my curry goat and oxtail and enjoying
what I should be doing.
You know what I mean, Coley? Enjoying all the stuff and everyone having a good time. And yeah. I hear this rubbish about Ollie and flipping. He's not good enough. He's not done enough. Yeah. And I'm just thinking, that last fan as well, like, you're talking about a man that's had to rebuild a squad of players that he didn't want, have time to implement them, and then also have to build a team that was believing a young group of players that were being implemented into the squad, like the likes of Greenwood, getting people like Rashford that's half fit most of the time, trying to get him to perform with, strikers he wasn't happy with, Pogba that wasn't playing. I think people have forgotten the state Mourinho left the club in. The same state he left, you know, Ambrose, you could tell them, Mr. Darren, like what he's done at Tottenham, he did to us first. And I was saying to everyone at Tottenham, I said, listen, you don't want this guy. He's past his best. We're living off old memories of Mourinho. He completely destroyed our club. He set us back nearly as far as Moyes did when he first came in. And Ollie had to come in, do that, change around everything at the club, going through Champions League in that first season, then coming in, bringing in the players that he wanted. Crooksy, come on, man. As a fan, you've got to get behind the geezer. Like, he's done more than what any other manager's done since Ferguson. And at the time, we're talking about second place. Like, it's, bro, we're not Arsenal. We're talking like it's Arteta at our club at the moment. Like, the geezer's about to relegate us.
Yeah, it could be that bad, yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
But he hasn't done more than any other manager, because other managers have won trophies. Other managers have finished second, which is what he did last year.
Yeah, I understand that. But, Cooksy, if you're a Man United fan, are you happy with the FA Cup and celebrating that as a trophy that you've won? Come on, if you're talking about really winning trophies, we come from... I'm in my mid-30s. I've been blessed enough to see my club win everything in the last 30 years, 25 years, from the 90s going into the mid-2000s with Fergie. I'm full up, mate. I weren't starved at any point growing up. Like, I can take a little 5 years rebuild. He's been in a job 2.5 years and you want to get him out. Do you know what I mean? It's like you being at work and then doing well at your job.
Yeah, progressing.
You know what I mean? Hitting 75% of your targets and progressing.
Yeah.
And then being told by your manager, mate, pal, listen, you know what? You haven't got me that big contract from whoever you was meant to get me the contract from. I set you a target of maybe 5 of them, but I really wanted you to get 10. But
that's what I said, 10, see?
I'm going to kick you out of the job. It makes no sense what you lot are saying.
Yeah, like, that's what I'm saying. He's building, isn't he? He's building.
He's got Sancho in. He's got all the players playing properly. Pogba believes that he can be at the club to an point if he didn't have Raiola as a geezer that was looking after him. But we've got geezers at the club. Maguire, listen, does Southgate deserve to be fired because he didn't win the trophy this season in the summer?
I think there are big similarities between Southgate and Ole Gunnar Solskjaer.
Yeah, but should we fire him? Shouldn't he get the contract?
I haven't necessarily said that he should be fired. I think if you're going to give him a new contract, give him a two-year contract.
He's going to get fired, no?
Give him a two-year contract and say you've got
what
2 years.
Between that, like, it doesn't matter.
Well, it's a year.
If he doesn't get what he's supposed to get in the next 18 months, he will be fired. If he doesn't get us from this summer a Premier League title, Champions League finals, what we expect as Man United fans, then fair, that's fair. But you deserve at least a 3-year cycle of implementing your players, yeah, getting people on board with what you're doing, building a squad, building a culture. These are things that we're just flying over, like the other guy talking about Tuchel. He walked into a job with superstars in every position. We're comparing ourselves to Man City that are backed by a state. They're not a football club managed by owners that are just millionaires. This is a country. They're being funded by a country with two world-class starting elevens. And you're comparing us about... And he said we wasn't close. The league was close up until about March. And then we had a couple of injuries. Pogba went out and then it was done.
They were never going to win the league.
This is a passionate man.
Mike, this is outstanding.
This is a passionate man.
Mike, we could probably keep you here all the way till 8 o'clock, but unfortunately we have other items on the agenda.
That was one of the best calls I've ever had. Look, he shut Alex up. He's just shut you up. Now you understand what they're thinking. All right, brilliant. Go on, Sam.
I love the passion. Keep them coming.